Vincenzo. Vincenzo.
Yes.
Do you wanna marry me?
Oh.
Give me your finger.
Oh, which my one God. This one is already taken.
Ah, oh, that's it. Let's give it this one. Let's see. Oh,
so romantic.
That's the best ring you can get.
Nice and heavy. You don't need a diamond ring.
When you're angry, you can eat your ring. You
know? Oh, yeah. I'm in angry case, now. Hi and welcome to
Vincenzo's Plate
and welcome to Ottavio Bonaccorsi from
the Laboratorio Artigianale Bonaccorsi, the lab,
the artisan pasta lab. You know, here we have the master of pasta. He makes everything by hand, which means made with love.
That's it.
Always tastes better.
That's it, absolutely.
And he's showing us how to make tortellini, an amazing Italian creation.
Yeah.
And what's the story behind tortellini?
Oh, Vincenzo, that's a recipe coming from the central Italy, the Emilia-Romagna region on the Adriatic Riviera.
Where the lasagna is from,
the mortadella, the prosciutto,
the parmigiano.
And that's the tortellini and pasta dough, prosciutto, mortadella. The best of it all in a fillet pasta,
little thing. So you're gonna show us how to make a classic recipe.
That's it, the super classic one.
Let's say thanks to Byron. Thank you, Byron, for requesting this video. What a better person, what a better chef can make it for you.
It's a great pleasure to make it for you, Byron, and the rest of the guys. And
for you, Byron, for you.
Let's get going. All right, guys, so we start with the pasta dough, the pasta fresca, okay? Pasta all'uovo, 1 kilo of 00 flour, 10 whole egg, pinch of salt, a touch of extra virgin olive oil to make it nice and shiny and elastic, okay? So you start to making a beautiful fontaine at the well. So we've got a 00 flour, you put it down, 15 grams of salt, put the eggs in the middle and work with your fork all around it to take the flour in, and then you start working with your hand.
You start always fold the flour into the egg, fold and take.
A lot of work with your hands. Go, 10, 15 minutes and the dough.
I do pasta, I don't need gin, that's my gin.
When you form a nice little ball, you come back, you put in a cling wrap and you leave it there for half an hour.
So many memories, Vincenzo, making dough by hand, you know? So beautiful process.
Now, what's next? We're going to prepare the filling. Filling easy. We're gonna use today a beautiful beef brisket. We trim a little bit of extra fat, which we don't need it. We cut it in even sized pieces of 2 centimeters square, and we're gonna put in a hot pan with some extra virgin olive oil, carrot, touch of celery, onions, and 1 clove of garlic. A little bit of bay leaves, 5 leaves of bay leaves, and now we need to brown the meat a little bit. Once the meat is nice and earthy browned, we deglaze it with a touch of white wine, we cover up and we let it cook for at least 45 minutes to 1 hour. All right, Vincenzo, now the meat is ready. We're gonna take it out the garlic. We don't want the garlic to go into the filling, and the bay leaf. We don't want the bay leaf to go into the filling. So take it out, scrape them off, take the meat, we just strain it out, leave it in a pan, let it cool a little bit, let it go a little bit warmer, it's too hot now to be grinded, and we start to do the other thing.
So
the
tortellini!
Hello! Okay, we start to mince our beautiful prosciutto. For 1 kilo of meat, under 50 grams of prosciutto and 100 grams of mortadella. We love the one with pepper, got a little bit more spiciness to it. We chop it down and we grind it finely. We can use a robot, a blender to do it, nice and finely, almost like a paste. We take everything because we want a paste, which is gonna be very nice, silky and smooth. We're gonna give these things another go in the mincer, another second layers of flavor. And go. And once the meat is cooled, you mince the meat twice, nice and super fine. So the mince is not been cooking for long. We need a little bit of texture over here. So we got roughly 1 hour cooking time. Depends on how big the chunks you cut. Try to cut all the pieces evenly. We mince the meat first time. We're gonna go for a second mincing process, okay? Number two, let's go first.
piercinghini più che altro.
Piercinghini.
I piercinghini. To do the mix, the actual filling, you put the meat on the bottom, you add the prosciutto and the mortadella, and you put a generous amount of Parmigiano Reggiano, at least 150 grams, 200 grams to taste, you know, to go with your taste. You add every kilo of meat, one whole egg, and 5 to 7 grams of nutmeg. So we're ready to go. Let's start mixing with our hands. Let's put our hands to work. Beauty. Oh, that's the best feeling ever. And you see the consistency of the filling. It's gonna be nice and malleable, nice and easy to work with. It's gonna stick together, but not be very runny. If it's too runny, don't worry. Little trick, you can add a little bit of breadcrumb to take all that juice to soak it up. If it's too hard, you put a little bit of the meat juice in it to make it nice and easy to work with. Now, the filling is almost ready. What we need to look is for consistency. We need to look at a piece of meat, which is, when you rip it out, it's gonna stay firm, nice and firm. This is the right piece of consistency we're looking at, okay?
And so, Ottavio, what do we do now?
Vincenzo, we're ready to roll the dough. Ready to rock and roll.
Rock and roll, yeah.
We're gonna use, to roll it down, because it's a bit nice and moist, we're gonna use a mixture of flour and semolina to make sure it doesn't stick to the rolling machine. Don't use it too much. We need the dough nice and moist. Because we're gonna use the machine, we're gonna put the dough on a centimeter thick layer and use the Ferrari. Always put flour on the pasta machine. We start from the highest number of you have on the machine. So in this case, we start from number 10, okay? And we start working through it slowly, one number at a time. So 10, and we do 9. We are about 2 millimeters, but we're gonna go thinner, as much as we can. You see the machine, you can see my hands through it. We are at number 1 now. You can see the color of my hands through the dough. That means that we are there. We reached the point of the thickness that we want. You like to have a square or about 4 or 5 centimeters. You enlarge it, you find your measure, clip it, and then you cut it. But if you don't have one of these, easy. Old school, a knife. So, Vincenzo, are we ready?
I'm ready.
So,
I'm ready to eat.
We got our filling. We got 5 centimeter squares. We put a generous amount in the middle, maybe a little bit less than this.
You're very generous.
I like the filling, you know. So now the filling is on the dough. We're ready to make the beautiful tortellini shape. And now we fold our squares in a half and form the little triangle shape. When we have this kind of a triangle shape, we pinch the top of it. We squeeze all the hair out from the filling. And then we're gonna make the beautiful shape of it, okay? Beautiful. If you feel that the dough is getting a little bit too dry and you can't close the tortellino properly, just put your finger in a bowl of water and wet the side, so it will help the dough to stick each other, to stick it.
Hold.
That's it, yeah. All right.
Close.
Nice. Bravo, let's all the air out. And voila, let's cook it. Hot water, pinch of salt, put the tortellini in it, let it boil. 3 minutes, ready to go. So now we're ready to take them out. And we go straight in our meat sauce. So that's basically the juice of our meat. Leave it there. It's gonna take exactly 20 to 30 seconds as soon as it starts to boil. And we're ready right now, Vincenzo. We don't need to put any Parmigiano, we don't need to put anything on top now.
Ottavio, this is the most exciting part of the day.
Nice and sharp for it.
Let's go.
Let's dig in.
Oh, the texture is already good, I can tell from the fork.
Fantastic. I'll cut it through, you see that? You can see the filling.
My God. The broth is incredible.
Fantastic.
But the texture, the tortellini flavors.
Melt.
I'm back in Italy right now.
The outside pasta, as soon as you put it in your mouth, it melts away. Yeah. It leaves with this back taste of prosciutto, mortadella,
yes,
and the meat. I love it. I really would like to thank you, all the Italians that invented this pasta. and keep the tradition and pass it to us, and we pass it to you guys.
Thank you guys from Bologna, from Modena. Oh, you guys fighting each other
guys.
To make the best tortellini.
Keep going, keep fighting.
Please, yeah.
The more you fight, the better the improvement.
Yes.
The better recipe we get, the best pasta we can make.
We have to be critical about food because that's the only way to improve.
Oh
yes.
My God.
Michael, this is great.
It was sauce all over my hands.
You can't do better than this, my friend. This is really good.
Thank you.
This is perfection.
That's nice. This is ridiculous.
This is perfect.
Yeah. Look, I wish you guys can taste this, but you actually can taste this. Just come over to the lab, ring, phone, call me, come and get it. I'll come and deliver it to your house.
Check it on Facebook.
The lab.
You're in Concord, Sydney. Wow. Thank you guys for watching this episode.
Thank you very much,
guys. We'll see the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe.
Yeah, definitely.
E ora si mangia.
That's it, let's dig in. Vincenzo's Plate.
Thank you.
I told you, I said it all the time, even at home. Sometimes I'm doing things, I say, Vincenzo's Plate.
It's obsessed. Hi and welcome to Vincenzo's Plate, ricordo?
Ma pure a casa lo dico ogni tanto. A casa, ma sveglio la mattina. Welcome to Vincenzo's Plate. Allo specchio me la dico. Cazzo sei tu non lo fai da solo, la mattina non ti svegli, non te lo fai da solo.
Sì, sempre. Every morning, hi.
Da solo.